animation, and we will be gonna see how we can use JavaScript for animating stuff. So let's begin by knowing from where we can download this image, how to modify it according to ourselves, and then work on it. So first of all, let me open Undraw from where I have just downloaded the image. So this is the website that I use to download my SVG image. After downloading, I open this image in Figma because it is a free software that allows many things and it really helps us to manipulate our SVG image according to ourselves. So I just open this image in Figma. After opening image in Figma, I just manipulated it according to myself. Like I just removed this big trees and small trees, and then I just dragged all the components over the phone so that it looks like it bumps out of the phone. So after doing that, I just grouped the like button because it was having two parts. Let me show you. So it was having two parts basically. One was this white background and the other one was the blue background with some partiality. So I just downloaded this I just grouped them, and then I grouped this girl, and then within the girl I grouped this her hand so that we can make it give it some animation. So let us now open Visual Studio Code. And yeah, before opening your Visual Studio Code, it is recommended that you export this image while clicking on this plus button and then selecting the whole image, then selecting SVG, and after clicking on this three dots, please check this button that says include ID attribute, because we have to select every component of our image and then we have to give animations to those components. So to identify each and every component, we need to provide them some IDs. So please check this box, and after that you just need to click on export and nothing else, and just select the thing that you want to export and deselect all the things that you don't want to export. So after exporting, just open your Visual Studio Code, open that image that you have just exported in Visual Studio Code, copy that image code and paste it in your HTML file. So I have already pasted the code in HTML file, and I have linked this style.css file and index.js file, which is our JavaScript file, because we are using JavaScript also in this video. So let's see how we can make animation for components like social media or emojis popping out of our phones. So let us see how we can make this using CSS and HTML and JavaScript. So first of all let us see our HTML file in live server. So this is our HTML file in live server, and let me close all the other components and minimize it so that we can parallelly see what we are doing over here. So first of all, let me remove all the margins and paddings that is given by our browser. So margin is equals to 0 and padding is equals to 0. So after doing this, let us give this a background color. So BAC. Okay. First let us select our body and then provide this a background color of let me copy the same color that I have over here. So let us copy this color and paste it over here. After doing that, first of all, I have to give classes to our images so that we can access the whole bunch in JavaScript. So I have provided classes in this social media. Every media has its own class. Like this group has a class which is known as Vector, and this heart is also having a class. This heart is also having a class of Vector, so that we can access this class together. And after doing that, I have given the whole classes. I have grouped all the emojis of heart and likes, and then given them ID of social. So let us access that. So let us say that social, and then save dot, and this will be Vector. And after selecting all the classes and all those things, first of all, we will be giving this opacity of 0, so that we are not able to see it in our first go. Like when the animation has not begun, it should be not visible, and that's why I have given this a opacity of 0. So after doing that, let us first fix this image. So we will be selecting the div where this image is located, and after selecting this div, let me give this a position of absolute, then top 50% and left 50%, and then translate -50%, -50%, so that our image is in middle and in center. So after doing this, you can see that now we have our image in middle of our screen. So after doing this, you need to first of all create animation for the social media. So while creating animation, let us first of all use @keyframes and name it as pop. And after naming it as pop, we will be going from 0% 0% to 50% to 100%. And then we will be using two types of animation today. One will be translate, so that our bubble, or we can say our hearts and likes, should move upward and somewhat in right direction. And then we will be using scale property to make it appear like it is increasing its size from 0 to 1. So let's see how we can give that. First of all, we will be saying transform. So we will be also learning that how to give two properties, like translate and scale, we are using for this image. So how we can use these both property at one picture at a time, means how we can combine the properties of different transform. So first I will be giving this a translate. So let me give this a translate of suppose -15 pixels, and then it should be in -5 pixels, and then I will be giving this a property of scale, which will be 0, 0. So it will be having no direction in x-axis or neither in y-axis. So first of all, and we will be giving this opacity. We will be giving this opacity of 1, so that we our whole stuff is visible to us. So after doing this, we will be again copying it for 50%, and this time we are gonna give this 5 pixels, and this will be minus 80 pixels because we want our social media, or we can say our likes and our hearts, to be from down towards upward side in y direction, and we want a slight difference in our x axis. So we have given this a value of 5 pixels. So again I will be pasting the same thing in transform, and this time it will be like 10 pixels, and this will be like minus 150 pixels. So we have created our animation, and yeah, this one will be 1 1, so that first our bubble, or we can say likes and hearts, must be from 0 to 1, and then it will be decreasing its size. So it will be increasing its size and then it will be decreasing its size. So after completing this, you need to first of all give now we have to access this element in our JavaScript, because we don't want every element to come at a time. Like if I will be saying here only animation, and suppose I say that pop pop, and then I say that let it be for 2 seconds, and then I say that it should be for infinite time, linear, and yeah, so it is not good. Like every media, or we can say every like and hearts, will be coming together and we will be going together. So to have some gaps between them, first of all we need to access our heart and like element in JavaScript. So for that I will be saying that const emojis, and let it be document dot get, or we will be using query selector. So we will be using query selector all, and we will be accessing our hearts and likes by saying hashtag social, and we want vectors of those. Like we have given this class names now, vectors to every element of social, so that we can access every element one by one. So I will be saying hashtag social. Okay, let me give this hashtag social, and then we will be saying dot vector. So let us print this emojis and check whether it is fine or not. So console dot log, and let us write here emojis. Cool. So let us open our developer tools, and yeah, here we got the node list of all the 5 elements, 0 to 4 indexes, for which we are gonna give animations. So let me close this and again go to my Visual Studio Code, and here let us remove this. And simply now we have to get one element at a time. So for that I will be saying emojis dot for each, and here we will be having our e, and we will be having i for indexes. So this will be like e dot style, style style dot animation, and here we will be having like name of the animation. It should run for 2 seconds, it should be for infinite times, and then it should be a linear animation, and then it should be having some delay, and that delay will be counted using this index. So it should be i divide by suppose 5 plus 0.2 and it should be in seconds. So this is the delay time for each and every element that is present in this emojis. So let us see how it looks right now. Okay, it is not working. Why? But let us see our... Okay, this should be style, not get element. So it should be style, style, e dot style. Okay, now you can see that every element is coming one by one, but it is not coming the way we want. So we need to fix this in style.css. And here we will be saying that transform origin must be center, and here transform box should be fill box. So we will be having this as fill box. Cool. Now it is coming the way we want it to come, but still we need to adjust some of the things, like we need to make it move towards right somewhat. Oh, let us this, yeah, we need to now adjust some translate and then look to this again. So for that I will be using, yeah, I will be adjusting it from here. So it's coming right away. So let me give this 10 pixels and okay, so with this, yeah, now it has shifted and cool. Let us add some much more delay to it so that it looks like it is coming one by one. And let us divide this with 4 instead of 5. Cool. So here let us give this opacity of 0.8 and let us give this opacity of 0. Well, now it is looking very much fine the way we created before. So this is for our social media, and now let us give styling to our hand. So first of all, I will be selecting my hand, then I will be creating one animation for my hand, like create frames, and give this a name of move. After giving this a name of move, I will be saying that from 0% to 50% to okay, it should be percent, and it should be till 100%. And here I will be saying rotate z axis, or it should be rotate z axis only. So it should be rotate z axis, but before that it should be transform. And yeah, we have done stuff. So we have just created our animation, and yeah, here we will be giving 0 degree, and I will be copying this and pasting over here. Here we will be having a slight animation, so it should be 5 degree and then again 0 degree. So let us see our hand now. Okay, we have just created the animation. Now we need to apply this animation to our hand using animation. So it will be like move 1 second, or let us give this 2 second for infinite times, and it should be a linear motion, and there should be no delay in it. And after doing this, we will be saying transform origin must be top, I guess. Yeah, let us keep this top for this. And let us give this a transform box fill box. So now our hand is also moving. So that is it for today, guys. I hope you like this video and you learn something new in animation. Again, we have used animation delay today to make it more realistic, and it was really fun creating it. So thank you guys for being till now, and if you really like this video, please